For the Hogs, the Texas game is the game of a football season. The series has had legendary coaches and All-American football players. It is steeped in tradition. In 1969, it was Royal versus Broyles as these teams met in the game of the century. Texas number one, Arkansas number two in the 100th year of college football. The Longhorns came from 14 points down to take the lead, and Tom Campbell's interception saved the national title.
For a team to be behind 14 to nothing, and then not to lose its cool and to go on to win, that proves you deserve to be number one, and that's what you are.
In 79, Fred Akers' Longhorns were unbeaten and ranked second in the nation. Arkansas under Lou Holtz was number 10. It had been 8 years since the Razorbacks had beaten Texas. Arkansas took out that frustration right here at War Memorial Stadium in Little Rock as Gary Anderson got the winning touchdown in a 17-14 victory for the Hogs. Last season, Fred Akers was fighting to keep his job, and Ken Hatfield wanted his first win over Texas. The Razorbacks hadn't won in Austin since 1966. It was 14-all at the half, but Joe Johnson's second-half touchdown was the difference in a 21-14 win, and Ken Hatfield got the victory ride he wanted. First-year Texas coach David McWilliams wants his own ride today in first place in the conference. This is War Memorial Stadium in Little Rock, Arkansas. More than 53,000 are here to see Texas and the Razorbacks fight it out for the lead in the Southwest Conference. And right now, these are the only two unbeaten teams in the Southwest Conference title chase as Texas A&M winning big over Baylor this afternoon, which makes both of those teams 2-1 in the Southwest Conference. Arkansas has won the toss. They declined. Texas will receive as we start the ballgame, and that's Kendall Traynor, who will kick it off for the Razorbacks of Arkansas. Eric Metcalf, number two. Tony Jones, number four, deep to receive. But a lot of teams like to kick it short to Texas because they're so dangerous. Jones is eighth in the country, so Chris Samuels, 23, and Dean Cockrell, 33, standing at the 20-yard line. Get a lot of returns, but Traynor will rip this one deep. And there will be no return at all for the Longhorns, who will start from their own 20-yard line. Brett Stafford will start at quarterback. He's had a tough year. Eric Metcalf and Darren Norris are the running backs as they have gone more to the ground game. The receivers, Tony Jones and Gabriel Johnson. Stephen Clark is the tight end. The interior of the line, Cunningham and Nielsen, are the tackles. And the guards and the center, Paul Jatan, the best of the bunch. He is an All-American candidate, and they have Jorick Battle, number 40, in there as they go to the three wide receiver set, and now they have four in there on first and 10 for the Longhorns. Quickly on a flanker screen, and the tackle by Kerry Owens. Kerry Owens came through and really messed up the play as they went to Tony Jones on the quick screen.
Tony Jones didn't have a chance that time. It was a quick screen, but the reason that play didn't work is number two, Metcalf, did not touch 54 Owens. He was supposed to block him. You probably say, what a lousy play. Well, if number two standing there would have blocked 54, it would have went for 75 yards.
At 178 pounds, blocking is not the long suit for Terry Metcalf. Battle goes out. They'll put Stephen Clark, the tight end, back to 82 on second and 13. Delay. Metcalf trying to get outside. Owens slowed him down. They knock him out of bounds at the 22-yard line. And the final hit put on by Albert Harrison, Anthony Cooney. That is a staple of the Texas running game when they go to that delay.
Well, what they like to do, basically, is give the ball to Metcalf as many different ways as they can. That's a nice way to give the ball to him. They don't have to throw it to him. Oh, they go back and hand it to him. It's hard to intercept one of those handoffs.
Kerry Cash, number 19, checks into the ballgame for the first time. He's on a wing along with Metcalf. Norris, the remaining back. Four-man rush, plenty of time. That's tipped at the line of scrimmage and almost intercepted. Tipped up by David Schell, number 70. You've got a hand on it. There is Tony Jericho cheering on this crowd.
a hand on a ball, and 64 Cherico gets an interception. 64 Cherico's playing in the middle of it. Champagne and almost intercepted right there. If he'd have got that, would have picked it up and scored, he'd be the leading receiver on the defensive line.
That's right. Alex Waits is into punt. Back to get it, John Bland, number 16. Bland at the 38, sidesteps the first man. And get a nice return out of it, up to his own 46-yard line. Take a look at that Arkansas offense, and banged-up Greg Thomas, the senior quarterback, will come out and lead this offense that features Johnson and Rouse at the halfback position and fullback Sammy Van Dyke. The tackles are big, Apolskas and Beckett, 272. Derek Russell and Billy Winston, the receivers, as you saw there, are the tackles. The interior of the line, Mike Benson starting at right guard for Freddie Childress, who has been on disciplinary suspension but is expected to be back in there today. First down, and Thomas, who has only thrown 10 times all year, goes deep, and it's dropped. Derek Russell had it right in his hands. It would have been a touchdown. Strohmeyer was two steps behind on the coverage, and Thomas laid it right on the money.
Derek Russell, number two, was named the high school player of the year in the state of Arkansas. Watch him run by number 44, Strohmeyer, with great speed. But what he does here is he takes the eyes off the ball at the last minute. Instead of reaching out and just cradling it and making another 2 or 3 yards, he tried to make a sensational catch of a perfect pass by Thomas.
Thomas all year has passed for 42 yards. That would have been more than he's thrown until this point in the season. A whistle, and it looks like we'll have a delay on second and 10 against Arkansas. Thomas really unloaded on that one and put it right in the hands of Russell. He's playing in place of Donnie Centers. It's a procedure call against Arkansas. That'll cost him five. Russell was in there because Donnie Centers, the starting split end, is out for disciplinary reasons. He's off the team. Here are the defensive ends for Texas. Duncombe and Aldridge, the only senior up front, number 97. The tackles are big. Llewellyn at 270 and Hackamack at 282. In this 4-3 defense, the man in the middle, the most important, Britt Hager, number 60, leads the team in tackles. Corners, Griffin, Richard is out of there. Fred Strohmeyer is in his place. Senegal and Hagee, the veteran safety. Second and 15, and Thomas on the roll, throws intended for Horton and thrown over his head. Strohmeyer out there on the coverage again. Strohmeyer, a sophomore, 5'9", starting in place of redshirt freshman Stanley Richard.
And that's a good point. All of a sudden, upstairs, they notice that number 18 is not starting the ball game, and they immediately go on the second team guy. Nice strategy by the Texas team. And Mike, most of the time you find that out in the pregame warm-ups. You study the opponent's starting lineups in the pregame warm-ups and knew that Richard would not be in there.
Third down, 15 for Arkansas. Delay. And Rouse breaks it back the other way. Has some room to run the midfield. Tackle made by Berman, number 22, the free safety in there on nickel coverage. And they'll have to punt the ball away.
Football is just inside Texas territory. It is fourth down and six.
Or at least we assume they'll punt the ball away on fourth and six. They are huddling on the sideline and now send in the kicking team. Hogs are big here, aren't they?
Absolutely. One of the reasons why they huddle on the sideline is trying to keep them, defensive team, off the field and try to catch them for a penalty.
Texas late getting its punt team on there as Arkansas had delayed, and Trainer will float it up for Metcalf. Fair catch signal, and he makes it at the 19-yard line. So Texas will start from there after only a 30-yard punt. We're scoreless first quarter from Little Rock. And Texas, their second possession from their own 19-yard line. And Stafford will give it off to Norris, and Norris gets up to the 24-yard line where Kerry Owens makes the tackle. Let's just take a look at that Arkansas defense. Very happy to have Wayne Martin, number 83, back. He had a severe sprained knee. David Shell and Albert Harris also up on that defensive front. The linebackers, Whitted and Williams, are the two leading tacklers on this ball club. You've already seen Owens make a big play. The corners are Brothers and Cooney. Cooney with a lot of speed. And the safeties, a couple of big hitters in Otis Lloyd and Steve Atwater. Second and five, Texas. Go to a double wing. Stafford against a three-man rush near side, and it's complete to Metcalf at the 31. For a scoreboard update, Tim Brando in the studio.
All right, Mike, thank you. All the fans watching Arkansas, Texas, I'm sure, are interested in the goings-on in Waco. Let's show you. Texas A&M, a true freshman, Darren Lewis, one of the highly sought-after players in the country last year, scores, and the Aggies roll 34-10 the final, and both Arkansas and Texas have to deal with Jackie Sherrill's club. Let's get back to Mike Patrick and Lee Corso.
And that means, Tim, that Texas and Arkansas, the only two remaining undefeated teams in the Southwest Conference. This game is for first place. Metcalf, nice cutback, brought down at the 33-yard line, and it was number 83, Wayne Martin, out of Cherry Valley, Arkansas, a young man who just come back from a knee injury. He is their best pass rusher and a veteran defensive lineman.
You notice that now Texas is going to a little bit more running game. The first time they came out and tried to be a little fancy, they went backwards fast and they did go forwards. This is a little bit more of what Texas wants to do in this ball game if they think they're going to win it.
Second and eight. With Norris and Metcalf, they have their two best backs in the same backfield. Metcalf. Quick hitter takes him out to about the 37-yard line. Eric Whitted. Out of Dallas, Texas. A lot of Texas players on this Arkansas team.
Well, they're going on Jericho a lot, number 64, because he's a great player. But watch this. Now, as they come off the ball, number 54, Champagne gets a piece of them, and they try to hit the line so quick that Jericho can't get off of his blocks. Remember, that's one of the things about Jericho. He's only 6 feet, 242, and he doesn't shed big linemen as well as most people would like.
Carl Bradford, 43, is in there for number 68, Albert Harris. It's third and three, Texas. And Stafford can't get his players set as Jorick Battle didn't seem to know where to go on that formation. And he's got to use a timeout with 11:05 to go in the first quarter. It's Texas nothing and Arkansas nothing. Texas moving the football, facing a third and three at its own 37-yard line. Jorick Battle in the slot to the left. Stafford to Metcalf, first down and more. Metcalf to midfield and hit there by Eric Whitted, number 39, the linebacker.
We talk about Metcalf being a great receiver. Watch him come out of the backfield on that favorite play in the pros. He comes out, he's ISO'd one-on-one on the linebacker. He runs away, he just knocks down number 39, Whitted, and he can't cover him, and he makes a good play after he catches the football. The essence of pro football has gotten to the isolation of back on linebacker. That's the same thing now in college football.
13-yard gain. First time Texas has been in Arkansas territory. Metcalf on the toss. This time slashes through. Picks up about eight. He's near the Arkansas 40-yard line. Anthony Cooney, the cornerback, had to make the tackle.
This Metcalf is so quick. Watch. Number two. He can run it. He can catch it. He does everything. He gets a little toss sweep. Good block there by number 65, Soleil. 72, Nielsen gets a good block. The reason why that play was so good is he's quicker than the defensive players from Arkansas, and he hit the seam and made the good yardage.
Metcalf now four carries, 20 yards. He's had two big games this year on the ground, 145 versus Oregon State, 157 against Rice. They want to keep that productivity up. Chris Samuels, number 23. Who checked into the ball game and appears to have the first down. Eric Whitted made the tackle.
One of the things you notice about Texas' attack immediately right now, featuring the guys that can win the game for them. Metcalf, number two, can do that. And then they went right away, put Metcalf in motion, let him see everybody, and ran 23 who knew who he was. First down.
Every time Texas brings somebody off the bench, he's either a freshman or a redshirt freshman, one of the youngest teams you're ever going to see in college football. Stafford, they're really mixing the plays up very well. To Metcalf again, another first down at the Arkansas 24-yard line. Eric Whitted makes the tackle.
One of the things they could do is they've obviously watched the University of Miami film, because that's exactly
what
Miami did against them. They brought those backs out in those little areas. Now watch number two, Metcalf, come out and sit down in a little area. 39, Whitted is playing the zone, but he can't get over there quick enough. Miami did exactly the same thing to Arkansas that Texas is doing right now, and they scored a lot of points.
Good play mix so far for Texas. First and 10, Longhorn. And Stafford on a play that's timing was a little bit off. We'll get it down to the 20-yard line as the pitch went to Norris. And Jericho mixing it up a little bit with Stan Thomas, a redshirt freshman right tackle.
The game is to the 20-yard line. It is
Jericho, you wonder what he could do as a linebacker at 242 pounds. You mentioned how light he is as a nose tackle.
He can't run fast enough for a linebacker. He's fortunate enough to be at a team where they got a nose tackle.
Well, Jericho's already got it down and dirty on the artificial turf here at War Memorial Stadium. Second and six. Delay to Metcalf. With it. Came up from his linebacker spot and made the tackle with the 19 along with Kerry Owens. Scores coming in all day for you, of course. Rutgers in an upset. West Virginia rolls over Cincinnati as expected. Columbia. Boy, just a tough string there, losing to Yale, and you can pick out some of your favorite teams. Navy gets a win. They beat Penn today, a big upset for the midshipmen. And Wake Forest, the dreams of a perfect season go down. North Carolina over NC State by three. Right here, we're faced with a second and six for Texas. A flag down, a motion penalty.
5-yard penalty.
And that will cost the Longhorns five.
And 11.
It'll still be second down and bring up second and 11. A lot of conjecture about Stafford and the strength of his arm. A lot of people say he does not have the zip he used to. He had elbow surgery in the spring, and that's tough to come back from. But right now, he's 4 out of 5 for 28 yards, all the short variety. Metcalf behind Norris. Hurdles to the 22 and no more. And it was number 96, Kerry Crawford, that got the first piece of him and sent him up in the air. Crawford is the second-string nose guard behind Jericho.
The nose guard, you need at least three nose guards to play, because what happens, they hit you from all different kinds of angles in there, and that's good if they're giving Jericho a break in there. They'll probably bring it back real soon.
Third down and 7 for Texas. Scoreless first quarter. 7:47 to go. Jorick, battle number 40 is in, as the Longhorns will put 4 wide receivers in their pattern. Give to Norris on the delay. And Norris got down to the 16-yard line. He's going to be about 2 yards shy of a first down. Kerry Owens made the tackle. So that time, they go to 4 wide receivers and then run the delay.
Nice little call for one reason. If they don't go for the first down, they got it perfect for a field goal. That was a good call because it positioned the ball properly for a field goal also.
Wayne Clements, who has hit 8 out of 10 on the season, will come in to try to give Texas the lead. Putting down the tee at the 23-yard line, so it will be a 33-yard attempt for Clements. 6 feet, 175, a sophomore. Out of the hold of Rob McManus. He hooked it, and it's wide. Arkansas holds. And we're still tied at nothing. 6:51 to go, first quarter. Number 98 has checked into the defensive line for Arkansas. Fake to Metcalf, but they gave the ball to Norris, who crossed the 10-yard line. Norris stacked up by the middle of the line. Eric Witter and Tony Jericho.
What they're trying to do at Jericho, number 64, is they're trying to run at him real quick and let him take a stunt one way and an option read him. But the problem is the two linebackers, 57 Williams there and 39 Witter, are stepping up and stopping him. But that's all right. If they're in there, they can't be outside those linebackers.
They take Kerry Owens out of the ballgame and put in a fifth defensive back, Eric Bradford, number 14, on 2nd and 9. Texas will keep it on the ground, though. Metcalf ran into the quarterback, and he'll lose a yard. Number 83, Wayne Martin, messed that up, and a flag goes down at the 10-yard line.
By Wayne Martin. There's a flag on the play.
Maybe a hold, as one of the Arkansas defensive linemen was pinned, and it is a hold.
See, it'll be a half distance to the penalty. It'll only be a 5-yard penalty. He might decline this thing.
That's what he's already told the team to do.
Holding. Texas declined.
Omar Saleh, 65, the right guard, is the guilty player.
As he pulls around to the left there, you'll see him grab a hold. Nice job of hooking Martin and taking him on a down. He'd be on professional wrestling. That would be at least a 3.
Martin made the tackle anyway. If you're going to hold, you might as well take the guy out altogether. 3rd and 9 as they decline the penalty. Stafford runs the option, gives to Norris. He only got a yard, stopped by Jericho as he got to the 12, and Texas will have to punt the football.
Jericho's an outstanding player in the middle. Unless you double team him, he's going to really hurt you. He blocks off. They block off a number 54, Champagne, and he makes a good read down there. Your reason why Texas ran that play is so they could punt it right now and not turn it over.
Alex Waits averages 42 yards a kick. He was second in the nation a year ago. This one just floats out of there. And back to get it, Horton. And Horton can't go anywhere. Dumped at his own 47-yard line. More scores for you, and there have been some shockers this afternoon. How about Syracuse leading Penn State? Harvard over Dartmouth, 42-3. That is a final. Scores out of the East. Brown beats Cornell. You can pick out your favorite team as you go along. Tough year for the Service Academy. South Carolina just laid it to the Virginia Cavaliers, who have been up and down. East Carolina, surprise over Virginia Tech. Jim Kessinger, number 95, checks in at tight end for Arkansas in this possession from their own 47. Van Dyke, the first option, carries for maybe 2 yards. Lee Brockman, number 63, a 6'2 junior, made the tackle. We invite you to join ESPN tomorrow for NFL primetime, bringing you all the highlights from all 13 NFL games. And we're almost back to normal, aren't we? Airtime, 7 o'clock. Join Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, and Pete Axtelm for the most comprehensive wrap-up of Sunday's NFL action, and it is. It's a great program. Hope you'll join us on ESPN tomorrow. 2nd and 9. Russell is back in the ballgame at the split end. Thomas in trouble. And he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a couple on this. Bobby Duncombe and Lee Brockman were in there.
Lee Brockman, number 63, is playing in place of number 48, Dwayne Duncombe. Duncombe has looked like he didn't play well in the Oklahoma game, and he started Brockman here because he's a bigger, stronger guy. The play was caused that time by very fine coverage by the secondary of Texas.
Paul Berman comes in as the nickelback on the Texas defense. 3rd and 11. Horton, number 3, is in at the split end for Arkansas. And Thomas wants to throw. Plenty of time. Intercepted. It's picked off by John Hagee. Hagee to the 10. And Thomas shoves him out of bounds at the 4-yard line. John Hagee, who already had a 29-yard touchdown return this season, picks off his second, goes 49 yards.
One of the worst situations in the world for a running team is they have third down and long yardage. And watch Thomas. He's looking for the tight end, but Hagee comes out of the right-hand side of your picture out of nowhere and gets by him and takes off. Now, Thomas is competitive enough to catch Hagee and knock him out of bounds right here, at least to give the defense an opportunity to have a goal line stand.
It is 1st and goal from the 3-yard line. Hagee has played every position in that defensive secondary in his career at Texas. Got the full house backfield now as Samuels, number 23, checks in. Metcalf is the deep man. He'll get the ball. Flag is down. They had movement. And he's knocked down a yard behind the line of scrimmage. Ricky Williams made the tackle. And it is going to be a motion penalty against Texas. Turnovers and mistakes have plagued the Longhorns.
Well, I don't know if they'll stop him or not, but that play by Thomas could come back to win this ball game for him. In other words, once you threw an interception, you don't give up. And Thomas caught Hagee and knocked him out of bounds. At least gives the defense a chance to stop him.
Motion on the offense. Still first down. We'll play one more down in this quarter.
You understand that the quarter can't end on a penalty, and that's why they're getting it first down. There's Thomas right there talking to the coach, telling him, look, don't worry about it. Keep throwing, but look before you throw.
1st and goal, Texas from the 8. Stafford on the option to Metcalf. He's got room to run. Touchdown, Texas. Terry Metcalf with his 4th rushing touchdown of the season has Texas on top on the final play of the first quarter. And the Arkansas crowd is not real happy about it.
Not real happy, but I want you to watch Metcalf run around the end. And if you get a chance, watch 34 Norris make the block that gives Metcalf the touchdown. After this play, we'll see it.
This is Wayne Clements, who hasn't missed an extra point in 2 years. Knocks this one through. Excuse me, he's 14 out of 15 this year coming into this ball.
All right, watch. Down the line option. Right now, keep your eye on number 34, the left-hand part of your picture right there. Watch this. Boom. He knocks Brothers, number 9, down, and that's why Metcalf gets the headlines. We've said it at the top of the show that you cannot win without good runners but good blockers also. Metcalf does nothing more to just use his speed. The play was made by number 34, Norris, on a great block.
And he beat Atwater to the corner, so we'll start the second quarter after a break with Texas leading Arkansas 7-0. Texas leading at 7-0 as we start the second quarter at War Memorial Stadium in Little Rock, Arkansas. And Clements getting set to kick it away. And James Rouse is deep to receive. Rouse averaging 23 yards a kickoff return. But he is very dangerous back there. And in a game where running, at least according to the coaches, should dominate, scoring first is really a big advantage. Rouse trying to get it before it makes the corner and can't, and it's out of bounds. So Arkansas will start from the 20. There's those 8-yard scoring drives, and 5 of the 8 was because of a penalty.
But remember, one thing about Thomas, he's a competitor, his senior, he's coming back in there. They have not changed quarterbacks yet to number 4, Grovey. But I'll tell you what, another shot like that one, and I'm telling you, the hook's going to come.
He's only 1 out of 4 for 10 yards and an interception. Thomas has been banged up, but incredibly, he has only thrown for 52 yards this season. First and 10 from the 20. They'll give it to Rouse on the dive plays out to the 23. Scoreboard update. Let's check in with Tim Brando.
All right, Mike Patrick, thank you very much. First drive of the third quarter for Syracuse and the Orangemen all over Penn State. Another aerial to Tommy Kane from Montreal, Quebec. And Syracuse has a 34-0 lead, and they're taking away the Lambert Trophy, it appears. Back to Mike Patrick.
34-0. I tell you what, our producer John Wildhack went to Syracuse. They're going to have to scrape him off the roof of the truck before this is over. Second and 6 for Arkansas. Thomas, nice fake, and then gets it to Rouse. 40, 50, it's only speed, and he's driven out of bounds by Hagee at the 34. Perfectly run option by Greg Thomas.
You'll never, ever see a better option than that. Now he comes down. Watch. He fakes the ball to the Foster. Number 97. Remember, Aldridge makes the wrong move. He pitches it out to Rouse, and Rouse is going all the way. Number 17 comes from nowhere to knock him down. But that's why he's still in the game. He can run that option as good as anybody. Came down, read it perfectly that time, pitched it. Big, big, big play.
44-yard gain for Rouse, who now has 57 in the first half. Johnson, as that play was messed up a little bit, and Texas covers it in a hurry. Aldridge, Llewellyn, Hackamack, Hager, just about everybody is in on the tackle. It's 13:55 to go here in the second quarter. Mike Patrick and Lee Corso with you from Little Rock. Texas scores first after the interception and leads 7-0. Stanley Richard, number 18, has checked into the ball game in the secondary, along with Greg Eagland, number 42, sophomore, on 2nd and 9. Rouse goes to a wing. Foster, the first option, has the ball, gets maybe a yard as Steve Llewellyn wrapped him up in a hurry. And the home folks are getting a little testy.
That's right. Well, they don't understand. The option is when you come down, you're going to take what Texas gives you. Now, watch 93. That's Llewellyn. He plays off number 675, Benson, and makes the tackle. Now, that was a good play by Texas. They just cheered about 5 seconds ago. What a great play by running the option and making that guy take it. So that it's a kind of a guessing game. So far, it's about even between Thomas and the Texas defense.
3rd and 7. One wide receiver there as Thomas wants to throw. Good protection. Now he wants to scramble. got a fine block out there, got down to the 21-yard line, 22. It's going to be a first down. Senegal ran him out of bounds, but Joe Johnson threw a great block to get that yardage.
Oh, nice call, Mike, because I tell you what, Joe Johnson, we talked about his blocking ability. Now watch, quarterback will go back, Thomas gets good protection, he can't find anybody. Now he starts to run. Hackamack is knocked down, number 68, but 19 comes out of the left part of your picture right there and lays a nice block on number 92, Brockman, and goes all the way down. Good play by Thomas. This is what Thomas needed, one good drive.
Back to two tight ends now, Winston and Kessinger, and Winston will split wide to the right on first and 10. Give it to the fullback, Foster. Aldridge is in on the stop along with Hackamack.
You called Aldridge's number that time, 97, because that was exactly the same play that Aldridge came down and tackled the fullback the last time, but the quarterback pulled it out and run the option play. That time they gave it to the fullback, and he made 4 yards. Aldridge cannot win. There's Kenny Hatfield. He knows he needs a touchdown or at least a field goal to get back into this game.
Russell is back in number 2 on 2nd and 7 from the Texas 20. Fake to Foster. Thomas will keep it. Slipped one tackle. Got down to the 15, the 13. Hagee pulled the ball loose, but it was after he was down. Brockman made the stop, but Hagee reached in there, grabbed a hold of the ball, and now he helps Thomas up. And one of the Texas players is down.
Watch number 97. He can't win. First, he's trying to get the fullback. Aldridge misses the fullback. Now he misses Thomas. Thomas drives forward. They try to pull the ball out, but the ball was already down.
Still checking on who the Texas player is. And we'll check on his condition in a moment. 11:56 to go first half. Texas by a touchdown. The injury was Britt Hager, the middle linebacker, number 60. The number worn by the great Tommy Nobis, another outstanding Texas middle linebacker. And he is the key to stopping that flex bone attack. The middle linebacker has to do it.
The middle linebacker has to stop the fullback, and that's why it's so important. Dean Weber is the head trainer at Texas. He's been there for 15 years, and he's worked with the 1984 Summer Olympic team. He's getting good treatment.
In there now is number 47, Robert Sullivan, as they go with a dive play down near the 10. Now, the difference in Sullivan, he's 5'10", 207. Hager, 6'1", 225.
An interesting substitution. They brought in Childress, number 72, at 395 pounds, whatever he weighs, and he blew the right side of the line, just went right over him. But in the clutch situation, you go your strength against their weakness, and Childress is their biggest, strongest lineman, right guard.
Childress at 350, that's before lunch. Here's the fullback, Foster, touchdown, Arkansas. The top of the show, the fullback must make yardage for this offense to work.
Absolutely. Foster did a great job that time by hitting the hole real quick.
The point after just got through, and we're tied at 7.
Now, Foster 18 hits the hole quickly, but the important thing is the middle linebacker is 47 right there. Number 50 right just runs right over 47. It's very interesting. It's very interesting. They bring out, they bring in the second linebacker. What do? They run the first two plays at him. Little things like that, subtle things like that you never see. White just creams Sullivan, and they get a touchdown. Two plays for Sullivan, two plays.
Ryan White is 288. Robert Sullivan is 207. We'll be back in a minute. 9 minutes, 51 seconds to go. Second quarter from Little Rock. Arkansas and Texas are tied at 7. And Britt Hager, the Texas middle linebacker, is still out of there. Robert Sullivan, number 47, is in his place, and we've got some scores coming your way. Oklahoma rolling as expected over Kansas State. That's in the third quarter. Nebraska having an easier time than many people thought against Oklahoma State, tossing a shutout. Auburn had to come from behind to beat Georgia Tech. LSU just continues to roll on toward the Sugar Bowl. Clemson, what a time Duke gave them, 17-10, and that game was at Death Valley. Delay to Rouse. bounces off Hagee and gets out to the 37-yard line. Aldrich had to make the tackle. Today's triple header continues when number 8 Tennessee goes against Alabama. That's a key SEC game. Then out to the West Coast to see one of the nation's top quarterbacks, Mike Perez, as he takes San Jose State against Fresno State. That's 10:30 Eastern time, starting live. So another big triple header on ESPN. We hope you join the ball game. This one is 7-7, second and 4 for Arkansas. They'll give it to Van Dyke. Bounced off the first tackle, then really got drilled as he got to the 48-yard line. And it was number 46, Bobby Duncan, who really pasted him.
You know why? They changed their defense that time. They jumped to a tight six defense and took the middle linebacker, Sullivan, and stuck him behind one of those big tackles to protect him. It looks like now what Texas says is we can't play the normal game with Sullivan in there. The last time they had this situation, they put number 72 in. They ran the fullback over the right guard and made a first down.
Also got their 17 tackles in there. Fritcher 66 and Allen 89. Third down, Thomas on the option. First down and more to the Texas 41-yard line. And it was Duncan again, number 46, who had to make the tackle.
There comes the option. Remember, the last time they ran it to the right, this time they come back to the left. Sullivan comes inside, misses the tackle on Thomas. Thomas keeps the ball wisely and goes down for a first down.
And Gerard Senegal, the strong safety, injured for Texas.
A lot of times you'll see injuries coming to the safety men and linebackers against the wishbone because they get hit from blind sides. There's so much action going on. That's why they get hurt a lot more than they do against passing teams.
Paul Berman, number 22, comes in his spot. And it's a first and 10 for Arkansas just outside the Texas 40-yard line. There's Hager, the middle linebacker, on the sideline. And Sullivan has had a tough time since he's been in there in his place. Because Hager's one of the best that's played that position at Texas, and that includes a long line of great players. Rouse, quick hitter straight ahead. And Roger Fritcher, number 66, was there on the tackle, along with Sullivan. And the Arkansas crowd is back into it. They're doing the wave right now. Berman is out. Senegal comes back in. And there goes Fritcher to the sideline as they'll send in back both starting tackles, Llewellyn 93 and Hackamack 68. Second and 6, Arkansas. Van Dyke, another big hole. Van Dyke to the 20, to the 15, to the 13-yard line. Hagee rode him down along with Sullivan. And Van Dyke rips off 24 yards.
24 yards because they ran the option play, and Bobby Duncan took the wrong man. Now watch, number 21 will go there. Now watch 46. He thinks that Thomas has still got the ball, and there goes Van Dyke. That was a perfect play of what Thomas did right. He came down, watched 46. 46 took him. Boom, he gives it to 21 for a big game.
Frustrating defense to play. This is Rouse trying to go to the outside. Senegal drives him out of bounds at the 7-yard line. And Arkansas's defense, which was almost picture perfect a week ago against Texas Tech, has got it going again.
Also, another reason, as soon as Hager went out of the ball game, the team has completely started to dominate Texas because the middle linebacker, 47, cannot play that position. McWilliams knows that. He's got to change his different defense. He's in trouble right now because of one player being gone, that middle linebacker, Hager.
Tony Holmes, number 26, comes into the ball game as they'll go with two tight ends. Rouse came out. Johnson. Oh, did he take a shot? Number 93, Steve Llewellyn, stopped him in his tracks. Hackamack helped out on the tackle. And those tackles become a lot more important without that middle linebacker to be so effective.
Right, what they did that time, they pinched the tackles. Watch 93 come to your inside Llewellyn and make a good play. But let me tell you something. Mike, when those tackles are making the play inside, watch out for the option. You score every time the tackles, Llewellyn and Richards and Hackamack are staying on the inside. You score every time with the option.
Rouse is back into the ballgame. Holmes comes out. It's 3rd and 4, Arkansas at the Texas 7. Thomas on the option. He keeps. Touchdown, Arkansas. Thomas, who has been banged and bruised all year, is slow getting up, and my partner Lee Corso called it exactly when the tackles pinch, it leaves the outside open, and there it was.
And Arkansas knows that. They know the offense very well. What happens if you can keep the inside three guys with the fullback, there's nobody that takes the quarterback or the pitch man. Now, there comes the option play. He'll fake the ball to the fullback, and everybody will hit the fullback, and out comes the option. He reads it, cuts it inside, touchdown. Now, if Thomas is hurt, they'll bring in number four, Groby. And if they play the same way Texas does, Groby will make 170 yards rushing in the second half because he'll go 60 yards with those long runs.
Thomas came into the ball game with a bruised shoulder, bruised ribs, right, and back, and a bruised sternum. And an option quarterback is going to pick up some lumps along the way. And now Thomas comes up, and he comes up with a fist in the air.
I always used to love that. The guy scores, he can't move, and all of a sudden he comes up. It looks like it's Sunday afternoon at North Little Rock.
Thomas, 8 carries, 40 yards and a touchdown. Passing only 1 out of 4 for 10 yards. Kendall Traynor is on for the point after, and he's got it. And Arkansas regains the lead against Texas. There is a flag down on the play, and they are checking with Arkansas.
Offside. On the defense.
Texas.
Points good.
Point
good. 10 lines on the kickoff.
So the point stands, and it's Arkansas 14, Texas 7, as Greg Thomas has given his club the lead. 5:39 to go in the half. Arkansas leads by 7. Quarterback Quinn Groby has checked into the ball game. The redshirt freshman from Duncan, Oklahoma. The Oklahoma State High School Player of the Year a year ago. And there is Britt Hager, who is back in at middle linebacker. Groby with a nice fake and then runs to the 35, to the 40. Hagee with a chest-high tackle brought him down at the 44-yard line. But Groby on the first play picks up 14 yards.
Well, he's got such tremendous quickness. It's the same bootleg that Thomas ran for about 4 yards. Watch, he fakes to the right, comes back to his left, gets a good block by number 74, Warrell, right there. And from then on, it's just great athletic ability. The guy's from Duncan, Oklahoma, the hometown of Texas A&M coach Jackie Sherrill.
5:23 to go in the first half. First and 10, Arkansas, leading by 7, bidding for more. Rouse. And Rouse only gets out to the 45, picks up about 2 yards. Hagee is in on the tackle again, along with Brockman. And Hagee just very, very active. Some Southwest Conference scores for you, because this game is for first place after Texas A&M knocks Baylor out of the unbeaten ranks. Both of those teams 2-1. Texas Tech blowing Rice away in the third quarter. TCU coming back, trailing by 1 now in the fourth period against North Texas State. And it's fullback Barry Foster.
Barry Foster carry.
Out to about the 47, 48-yard line.
Third down.
It's going to be third down as the scoreboard does not want to operate right now. It says first and 8. It's going to be third down and call it 5. And now the scoreboard back in action. Arkansas would like to keep possession of the football here. Foster and Groby on the option, outrunning Hager to the sideline. He's just got great speed and acceleration, driven out of bounds by Senegal. But he just ran away from Hager, who appeared to have an angle on him, but not for more than a second.
Hager's a great player, tough guy, wearing number 60, but he's chasing a jackrabbit in that number 4, Groby. Watch. Groby comes out with the option, and right now it's just pure speed. He can't catch him. The thing I like about Groby the most is the fact that he's got such great acceleration. He slows at one speed, and all of a sudden, boom, he puts the afterburner in. He's a good-looking prospect for a freshman.
He's coming to game 2 carries, 33 yards. It's a first and 10, Arkansas. And Foster is just plastered by Hackaman.
That's
oh,
okay.
My goodness.
I'm serious. That's okay. They just do that for bait. They just do that every once in a while to keep Hackenbach and those guys in there saying, nice play, Hackenbach, and then they'll run around the end for 35 more yards.
Does Foster know that?
Foster doesn't care. He's getting a scholarship, and and Groby's making the headlines, and Thomas making touchdowns. A fullback in the wishbone has got to be the most unselfish human being in the history of the world.
I don't know if I'd want to be classified, though, as bait.
Well, he is.
Second and 11. Foster will get it this time. It gets down to the 29-yard line, and that fullback dive play has been very successful today.
Well, you know why it was that time? They used him for bait again, except number 97 Aldridge went and hit Groby. He did, and he was gone before he helped. You cannot win if that formation and that offense is done wrong. You can't win. That time Aldridge made a great play, and the guy went 17 yards.
And Arkansas will use a timeout to stop the clock with 2:56 to go in the first half. Third and six for Arkansas. Grovey on the option. And Rouse didn't have a chance. Excellent play by Senegal. It came up from the strong safety spot to make the tackle.
This was the same option, but 95 Kissinger does not do a good job. Now watch the guy on the left-hand side of your picture. He's supposed to block out here, number five, Senegal, and he doesn't anything. He just follows around like he wants to dance with him, and the play's no good. If they'd have put Johnson out there, he'd have knocked the guy down, and we'd still be going.
Kendall Traynor is on to try a field goal, just over 50 yards. Traynor's long this year is 41, but he's got the leg to get it there. It's high, but it's going to be way short as he got under that one. So the score remains at 14-7, and Texas will have a chance to get back on the board with 2:12 to go in the first half. Texas, we're in Lincoln, Nebraska, where Arkansas is leading Texas 14-7, starting the third quarter, and Texas will kick off. We're in Little Rock, Mike Patrick and Lee Corso. And warming up on the sideline is Thomas and Groby, and it'll be interesting to see who comes in at quarterback. Here are the halftime statistics for you. It has been dominated by Arkansas with 232 total yards. They have also dominated the time of possession, which is what they like to do.
Arkansas has averaged 6.5 running the football, and Stafford is only averaging 6 throwing the football, 6 yards a throw. You've got to control the running game in the game of college football to win at least 80% of the games.
Wayne Clements will kick off as Texas gives up the ball, down by 7. Rouse is deep to receive, standing at his own goal line. Rouse at the goal line. Bounced off one tackle, got it out to the 19-yard line. Arkansas will start from there. And let's see who is the Arkansas quarterback, both standing on the sideline. Grovey came off the bench after Thomas was in.
He had Thomas throwing with the trainer watching him, but he didn't look like he had any zip in it, and he'll probably go with Grovey because of the fact that he's got that quickness and the speed, too.
They had ice on his throwing shoulder, and Britt Hager, we are told, had his bell rung in the first half. That's why he was out of the ballgame, but the star middle linebacker is back in there for the Longhorns. Rouse. Behind the block of Johnson, gets it up near the 24. Hagee, along with Hackamack, trailing the play, made the stop. Let's go back to the first half where Greg Thomas suffered that injury, and it was on the second Arkansas touchdown.
A little option to the left. He fakes the ball. He cuts it in right here, and he looks like he gets hit and goes down on his shoulder right there. And when he does, not only does the weight of the man fall on him, the ball does and everything else, and it looked like he hurt his shoulder.
He took the hit on the other shoulder. Second and 5, Arkansas. Van Dyke, the fullback, hit hard by Thomas Aldridge, the end. This brings up a question that Lee and I talked about a little bit last night. Greg Thomas being the senior quarterback, Grovey the redshirt freshman. And so often in college football, you hear about freshmen or redshirt freshmen, how great players they are, and coaches don't want to play them until they have to. Now, Thomas gets hurt. Grovey has a chance to play this year.
Two reasons. One, they don't want to put Grovey in a situation where he might fail. Especially young. If you fail young, you have a hard time getting the team back around you. And two, you don't do it because you're afraid of the criticism of people of going with young people.
Third and 4, Arkansas. They'll run the option again. Van Dyke diving forward. He's going to be shy of the first down. And Duncan was in on the stop for Texas. That's Bobby Duckham, number 46, as well as Brett Hager, number 60, the middle linebacker. And they stop Arkansas a yard shy of the first down. They have to punt it away.
Well, they ran the read option twice that time, and both times you're talking about Grovey made the wrong read. If he'd have taken that ball out, he could have gone around the end for at least 5 or 10, maybe 20 yards.
There is Metcalf, and he is the most dangerous man in this Texas attack. High, spiraling kick. Metcalf signals fair catch, makes it at the 34-yard line. And as Texas goes to its running offense, you'll see that Metcalf has more yards rushing this year than he had in the first 2 years combined. And here are the Texas possessions in that first half. First time they had the ball, they had to 11 yards and punted. Then they had an excellent drive that resulted in a missed field goal. Came back, had to punt again after only 3 plays. Then a 1-play touchdown, and that was off the interception by Hagee. Again, 3 plays and a punt, and 3 plays and a punt. So only 2 series outside of the last one that ended in an interception did they move the ball at all against the Arkansas defense. Stafford to throw on first down, off to Metcalf. Metcalf out of bounds at the 38-yard line. It's going to be a gain of only 4, and that is basically the Texas passing game, the short outs.
And they've got to be able to do that and do that and do that, but they've got to go up top. And the reason why those plays aren't making any more yardage is that Arkansas is keeping the people. They're in front of them, and then they're just moving them. Their average yards per attempt, 4.5, is not good enough to win. It looks good in the record book, but it doesn't help you win any games.
Second and 5. They give him a gain of 5 on the last. Metcalf, 62 yards rushing, 46 yards more receiving. And Norris fumbled the football. Texas got it back at the 41. David Shell was the man who stripped it, and Stafford, really hustling, got the recovery.
The nice thing about Stafford, he was alert on this play. After he handed the ball off, he did just sit around and have a popcorn and look for a cold drink. After he hands the ball off and there's a fumble, he goes after it. And the great thing about this is watch him just go and cover it, try to pick it up and run it. Excellent little play there.
Third and 3, Texas from its own 41. Stafford to Metcalf. Metcalf has the first down, got out to the 47-yard line, thrown back. They'll mark it near the 48. And it is the first down. Ricky Williams dragged Metcalf down and planted him on the artificial turf.
Metcalf is coming out of the backfield now. Eric Metcalf comes out of the backfield, makes a little move. He's going to go to the outside, and he breaks it to the inside. He's isolated on 54, Kerry Owens. He breaks a couple of tackles, and he moves first down. That's not a bad play on third down and 4 because you get 5.
Oh, Tony Cherko with a little action after the play was over. Reminds me so much of his dad, Terry, in his moves, his elusiveness. Kerry Cash in motion. This is Metcalf cutting it back. And Ricky Williams never gave him the chance.
Williams that time, 6 feet, 221, and a senior from Little Rock, really played it well. He's one of the 16 finalists for the Butkus Award, which is given by the Orlando Downtown Touchdown Club. A great award for a great linebacker.
Can you imagine winning as a linebacker something with Butkus's name on it? I think it'd be probably the biggest thing you could ever do.
Bosworth has won it 2 times in a row.
Yeah. Second and 11, Texas, at its own 47. Four-man rush. Shell with the pressure, and the pass over the middle is almost intercepted by Brothers. Tried for the diving catch, but David Shell, number 70, was coming hard after Stafford.
And was he coming? He's the only player from the state of New Mexico, David Shell. He's 6'4", 260. He puts a lot of pressure on him and knocks him down after. If that's not a sack, it's a scare, a real big yeah. Scare. Boy, that's real pressure by number 74. I mean, number 70, Shell. The reason he did a good job on that is he got high also, so he got the vision of Stafford blurred.
Stafford, 10 out of 16, 62 yards and an interception. Kerry Cash, number 19, is in there on third down. And they'll drop it off to Norris on the delay. A little screen, and Norris going for the first down and has it. Forced out of bounds at the Arkansas 36-yard line by Anthony Cooney. Now, there was a play where they sent Metcalf out, and he literally cleared the area out, then they dumped it off to Norris.
It was a decoy, and that's the run and shoot. That's the run and shoot offense. Watch this one. Metcalf will come out of the backfield. He is bait, just like the fullback is on a wishbone. They all watch him, but all of a sudden, underneath the 34, gets a nice little screen play. That was a perfect call by the Texas sideline.
Martin got to him just as he unloaded. Did you see Metcalf downfield trying to throw the block and keep the play going? Metcalf on the draw. And did Kerry Owens come up in a hurry to make the stop? Well, Metcalf is not going to go anywhere unnoticed.
Well, I tell you what, that's all right. That play is stopped in the inside, but it was a draw play, which means, if nothing else, if Owens, number 54, and Cherico are in the middle, then they should be able to throw the ball on those little zones that they've been throwing on. That's a good call because of the fact you've got to do that every once in a while to keep the pressure off your quarterback, Stafford.
Kerry Crawford, 96, and Chad Rowland, 51, into the Arkansas defensive line on second and 11. Stafford with plenty of time over the middle, and it's complete. He's got Kerry Cash, who has speed and size. Another one of the freshman Texas recruits.
What happens this time is you'll watch number two Metcalf will come out of the backfield, and he gets number 57. 57 drops to his right, 39 with it to his left, and they throw it in between them. But the reason those linebackers split is because they sent two backs out into the flat and made them split.
Gain of 10, so it's third and one at the Arkansas 27. 10 minutes exactly to go, third quarter. Arkansas leads Texas by a touchdown. Norris got the first down to the Arkansas 25. Norris, a strong inside runner, even though he's only 195 pounds, stopped by Kerry Crawford.
He's the only player from California on the Texas team, and I tell you, he's got great speed. He won the state of California 100-meter dash. And let me tell you something, if you win that race in California, you can fly.
You bet. Got a few guys out there who run 100 meters. You really think that's become the best high school football recruiting area in the country, don't you?
California 1, Florida 2, Texas 3.
On the option, Metcalf. Shot as he picked up three. Atwater nailed him after Lloyd spun him around.
You know, when they run the option play, the secret to the option is to get support from the secondary. Now watch, Metcalf will come down from a low angle. They run the option. Stafford fakes the ball to the fullback, comes down, pitches it nice. But watch 27 from the right-hand side of your picture, the safety come up. Atwater is 6'4", 205, and a big, strong support man.
Both Atwater and Lloyd are big hitters. 65 yards rushing so far from Metcalf. Second and six, Stafford to throw. Once again, dumps it off short and almost intercepted by Kerry Owens. Had the ball in his hands and couldn't hold it.
Guess where they were trying to throw it?
Yeah.
They were trying to throw it to the same man, Metcalf in the flat, and Owens this time got sick and tired of going on dropping against nowhere. He starts and watches the ball. Watch 54. Watch. He's watching the quarterback. He telegraphs the ball, and he gets a good jump, 54, Owens does, and almost intercepts it.
So that brings up third and six.
Mike, one point here. Whatever you do, if you're Texas coach, you're telling Stafford, look, do not throw the ball away. We need 3 points at least.
Last time Texas got within scoring range, they threw an interception, but only after a holding penalty took them out of touchdown range. Here comes the reverse to Jones. It took a long time to develop, and what a tackle by Owens! That reverse took longer than any other reverse I have ever seen to get there.
I tell you what, and Ed Owens is well coached. Watch. Here comes Stafford. He's going to his left. He pitches it out to Jones, number four. Number 76, Nielsen gets a good block, but there's that man, 54 Owens. There's got to be at least six number 54s out there because he is all over the field.
The ball spotted at the 28. It will be a 38-yard field goal attempt by Wayne Clements, who earlier missed from 33. He hooked the last one left. This one is dead center. And Texas is on the board here in the third quarter. 8:02 to go in the period. Arkansas 14 and Texas 10. And Wayne Clements, who just kicked the field goal, is on to kick off to James Rouse, who is standing at his own one. High floating. Rouse from the three. It back to the 21. Ball's loose, but Rouse was down. For an update, let's check in with Tim Brando.
All right, Mike, they'll be seeing this in their dreams in Happy Valley. Watch the story of the day. Late in the game, Don McPherson again to Tom Caney had two touchdown catches on the day. That would lead to another. You say, are they running it up? Not really. They wanted to have an extra point attempt that would give them the all-time record for 200 consecutive NCAA extra points. They got it from Tim Vesling, and Syracuse gets the win. Back to Mike and Lee.
Unbelievable day for the Orange Man. A lot of years of frustration taken out today. First and 10 for Arkansas at zone 21. They lead by four. Grovey is the quarterback to Van Dyke. The first man in the option up to the 26. And it was Hackamack once again. I can hear our producer, John Wildhack, headed out the door of the truck downstairs right now to catch that plane for the Syracuse celebration. Arkansas has gotten a lot of mileage out of that first option, and it really is the key to the wishbone, or the flex bone, as they call it here at Arkansas. Second and five. Derek Russell in as the wide receiver. Winston, the tight end, split. Give it to Van Dyke again, and Van Dyke ran right into linebacker Lee Brockman. Van Dyke used to be a tailback. Born in Paris, France, and has had dual citizenship. And at the age of 21, now he has to make up his mind, and he says there's no problem doing that. He will be an American citizen strictly.
He's got to be a fine young man to move from the starting halfback to the starting fullback in the wishbone. Because I tell you what, that is really a team player when you do that.
They really get fired up for football here in Arkansas. It's third and three. Grovey to Rouse. Oh, what a play. Coming up the corner, Stromile made the stop, and that's the way to support the run from the corner.
Okay, remember when Atwater, number 27, came up, made the great option play, and I said that you got to have support from the secondary to stop the option? Watch number 44. Good read, good fake there. Grovey pitches it out to Rouse, but here comes number 44, as you call it, Strohmeyer in there and makes the play. You cannot stop the option play without the safeties filling.
So the Texas defense does its job. Three plays and a punt. Trainer will have to kick it away. Metcalf is back. They got some pressure on him. And this is not a good kick because of that pressure. Out of bounds. Didn't get much across midfield. The officials mark it at the 41-yard line. Texas will start from there with 5:59 to go in the third quarter after only a 29-yard kick. Texas. 13:26 to go in this game. Arkansas 14, Texas 10. Longhorn ball at their own 23. Stafford dumps it to Metcalf, the guy he wanted to get it to in the first place, in Metcalf. Out across the 33 where Whitted puts him on the turf, but he's got the first down. Very rarely that Metcalf is going to be the checkoff receiver, and that is a school record, 8 receptions in one game. And here's some other scores to update you. Later starts and some games that are just wrapping up. Texas Tech on a roll against Rice, and TCU comes back to beat North Texas State. Southern Cal and Washington tied in the fourth quarter. But the quack attack is in trouble on the West Coast against UCLA. Metcalf made one move, got rid of a tackler, but couldn't get rid of Atwater as he got to the 37. Every possession gets to be so much more important now, especially since both clubs take a long time to score.
They take the ISO play to basically play off the I formation with Norris 34 leading him. Give the ball to him, let him find option run. Does a good job of option running, but he can't get away from number 27, Steve Atwater.
Second
double team
five.
On Jericho. Now, Jericho gets blocked, but he also gets strangled.
Metcalf. Jericho got him that time along with Ricky Williams.
They probably didn't hold him that time. The last time, number 54, Champagne, just jumped on him and grabbed him by a neck hole.
Well, they do things like that in the line, don't they?
Jericho's a fine football player. Now, this is ground level. It shows you that front line, it's got to get explosion, but he's right there in the backfield, makes a good play. You can block him sometimes, but percentages are he's going to come up with a good play inside.
Third and four, Texas, number 19, Kerry Cash is into the lineup at a wide receiver spot. He'll come to the near side. They have three wide receivers on third and four. Four-man rush. Stafford in trouble, and they got it. Tony Jericho put on the pressure. 98, Michael Shepard gets the sack and a great defensive stand for Arkansas.
Jericho, number 64. Number 83, Wayne Martin also. Jericho's in the middle. He does a little swim technique. He beats number 65, Soleil. He runs through another guy, puts the pressure on him to make the tackle. You know, the problem with Texas right now is they have no consistency. They try to move the ball. They try to do this, but they have no consistency. And there goes Cunningham, number 72, out.
He's the starting left tackle, and it looks like a right knee or a right ankle. And Texas has to give up the ball with 11:30 to go in the fourth quarter. Waits the punt. Horton is deep to receive. Waits just knocked the air out of it. Horton all the way back to the 10-yard line. And he can't get it back past the 17. Excellent punt by Texas. 53 yards from Alex Waits. 11:08 to go in a four-point ball game. They're on their feet in Little Rock. 11:08 to go in the game. Arkansas clinging to a four-point lead. And the Razorbacks will have it first and 10 from their own 17.
Last year when they had the same type of situation, Arkansas kept the ball for over 7 minutes and won the football game in Austin, Texas.
A field goal would put them up by seven. Barry Foster, number 18, will come in at fullback for Sammy Van Dyke. Grovey can't get outside as they ran the option to the short side. Thomas Aldridge would not let him cut back or would not let him outside. And here is an update on Southern Cal leading Washington by seven. That's a fourth quarter score. Now, Oregon has beaten both of those teams already in the Pac-10 race. And UCLA, a last report, was beating the Quack Attack. And here come some more scores for you. Number one, Oklahoma. Kansas State playing Oklahoma. They must feel like we're trying to bail out the Titanic with a teacup. And now we've got a delay. And Texas has had to take a timeout on defense. And that is a something that will come back to haunt you. We have a timeout with 11:03 to go in the ball game, and it's 14-10 Arkansas. The Hogs have it second and nine from their own 18-yard line. The last timeout was called because Lee Brockman, the linebacker, was injured, and they couldn't get him off the field in time. Fullback keeps it. That's Foster. And Hager in on the stop again, along with Ken Hackamack, the right tackle.
Texas that time had 11 men within 6 yards of the line of scrimmage. Now, it's very, very difficult to run the wishbone against 11 men, maybe 10. Hager is a good man in middle, but if Arkansas would fake one of those and go deep, it's all over because there's nobody back there to cover him.
Derek Russell late getting into the huddle for the tight end, Billy Winston, and Russell will come to the near side. He is a burner, the most heralded prospect they have signed at Arkansas in years. And Groby wants to throw. He's in trouble. But look at that speed. And it's Hager. Brent Hager, the middle linebacker, with an incredible play, came all the way across the field and caught somebody who's as quick as lightning.
Hager ran at least 175 yards on that play. He went left, now he's going right, now he's going to chase it down, and watch him. This is nothing but heart, ladies and gentlemen, from a 6'1", 218-pound All-American candidate, Hager, from Odessa, Texas. What a play.
And they did want to do what you've been suggesting. They didn't want to throw the ball, get that one man down there with all that speed.
But they did it off a cross action, not the option play.
Trainer to punt out of his own end zone. Let's make him down with ice on it. Metcalf has to signal for the fair catch at midfield. It's been an excellent day for punters. Trainer and Waits have done a fine job kicking, especially when they had to. 9:28 left in the game. Texas with the ball down by four.
We first.
9:28 to go in the ball game. Texas with the football at its own 49-yard line. Charles Cephas, number 78, is in at left tackle for Texas. A redshirt freshman. Stafford, deep sideline. Jones! Oh, what a catch! And the official was right there and said he kept the foot in bounds and what control.
Now remember, he must catch the football and have one foot in. Now watch, Stafford throws it real good. The reason he's got one-on-one coverage up there is two men are watching Metcalf. There's a good catch, he's got his foot in, good play, and number nine Brothers is just watching him one-on-one coverage. The reason why we're so wide open again, Mike, is two men took Metcalf short and left him alone longer.
Stafford had some zip on that one. Metcalf trying to dance for yardage, may have gotten one and no more. Cherico down there on the bottom of the pile along with Whitted. Coming up right after this ball game, 8th-ranked Tennessee against Alabama. It's live from Birmingham. Jim Kelly and Kevin Kiley bringing you that ball game. Alabama, of course, trying to rebound after being embarrassed last week against Memphis State. John Bland, number 16, is in the corner for Arkansas. That's battle in motion. Stafford to Jones on the flanker screen. Had a couple of yards and was bumped backwards, and that was Brothers coming up from the secondary and really popped him. They'll mark it, however, at the 34, and that's no gain, and they're still about 7 yards shy of a first down. And Southern Cal now trying to roll it up. Colorado beats Kansas. Houston over Wyoming by 1 in the 4th. And other scores, pick out your favorite. Biggest play of the game coming here, 3rd and 7. Kerry Cash is in for Texas. And it's complete. Texas has the first down as they throw to Gabriel Johnson. The first time the flankers touched the ball today, Otis Lloyd makes the tackle.
And they use Metcalf very intelligently as a decoy. Metcalf's the bottom of your picture, goes outside. Watch 54. Owens almost intercepted right there. But Johnson makes a good catch by catching it and before he ran with it. The decoy was Metcalf, the ball to Johnson.
Johnson does not have great speed, but he runs good patterns. Made a 17th catch of the season. Metcalf. Whitted has him at the 18-yard line. Williams also in on the stop. The clock ticking down, 7:33 and counting from Little Rock. Texas is down by 4.
14-10. If they kick a field goal, it'll be 14-13. They can still win the ball game with another field goal. But they should try to go for a touchdown this time, if at all possible, because this crowd gets into it any more. And I tell you what, they're going to have a tough time coming back in the fourth quarter.
And they do not have an offense that can get you down the field in a hurry. Same way with Arkansas. And you can see that they've had trouble scoring inside the 20. Stafford, quarterback draw. Williams and Whitted hit him as he gets inside the 15, and they continue to push him back, but he won't go down. Stafford is a tough kid, and I like what you pointed out in the first half, Lee, that he has had 3 offensive coordinators in 3 seasons.
Yes, and this is a planned play, Mike. In other words, what they try to do is get the linebackers to drop out on Metcalf and everybody else and then run it up the middle. But I'll tell you what, he's met by the whole host of those Hogs right there. But those 3 offensive coordinators are all different personalities.
Yeah.
They might teach the same plays, but they're different kinds of people. That's the problem.
3rd and 1, and might all ride on this. Metcalf, no. And it's Williams who just knifed through a gap in the line and made the tackle. Now, what a big decision for McWilliams.
No decision. Go for the field goal. Without a question, he's got to go for the field goal. Now watch, 57 comes in the middle there. Number 65, Chalet was supposed to trap him, but Williams was too quick in there. There's no decision here. He's got to go for the field goal, so it'll make it 14-13.
The crowd is on its feet on 4th and 3, and it looks like Texas will not go for the field goal. They'll try to pick up the first half. The game may lay right here. and it's incomplete. Arkansas holds and takes over. Stafford just couldn't find anybody to throw to, and the pressure finally got to him.
He wanted to get the ball to Metcalf, number two, but 54, Owens was on him, and he tries to get away from Jericho, but he can't get away. They knock it down. Now, the reason why I say you go for a field goal there is 14, it's 14-13. You don't have to go the length of the field the next time you get the ball, and Arkansas is reacting real good there. I'd second-guess the call, but it's a first guess. I said to go for the field goal before.
5:58 left. Arkansas has it at its own 15. Now Texas defense must hold to have a chance. Rouse ran out of one tackle, got out to the 15-yard line where Richard is there with him, along with Duncombe. Tim Brando has a scoreboard update, Ohio State and Purdue. Tim.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. Remember this man, Matt Franz? He missed a field goal try that could have given them the victory against LSU a few weeks ago. He hits it from 50 yards with 3 minutes remaining, and Purdue, without Duck Downing, who was injured, has the sophomore Sean McCarthy in the game now as they trail by three with 3 minutes left. Mike?
Greg Thomas has come in at quarterback for Arkansas in place of Quinn Grovey. What a time for Thomas to check back into the game. Remember, he was out earlier with a bruised shoulder. They had a big ice pack on it. Thomas keeps on the option, and Hager stands him straight up at the 24. Loose ball, but well after the whistle, and the Arkansas crowd did not like the fact that Thomas got roughed up.
Well, they got Thomas in the ball game, obviously, because he's a senior. He's been in this situation a lot, and he's a good football player. Now, in the middle is number 60, Hager. Number 50, White, tries to get him. 69, Apakas tries to get him, but Hager is all over the field and makes a nice defensive play.
And Greg Thomas really upset with the treatment he got. Talk about big plays. This is third and one for Arkansas.
Over the right guard, number 72 at the fullback. Third down and one.
And that's exactly what it is, and Van Dyke has the first down. Lee Corso knows from where he speaks.
Well, they got number 72 in there. He's 6 feet 9, 390 pounds, Childress, and he just blows everybody off. He's just playing percentage. Now, what's the problem with Texas is, if Arkansas just gets another first down, or maybe two, and punts the ball, they're going to get the ball on the 10, and they got to go the length of the field instead of going just for a field goal. That's why 14-13 is better than 14-10.
Childress, by the way, is back on the varsity after a couple of weeks of being on the scout team because of disciplinary reasons. Thomas on the keeper. Hagee comes up from the secondary. They dump him after a gain of about a yard. And now Arkansas would love to get the first down, but they are working on the clock, which is down to 3:53.
And they're going to hurt Thomas. There's no question in my mind that Thomas is smooth. He's a good player, but the guy is hurting. Now, the problem you have is if he gets hurt, he's going to have to call timeout and stop the clock. That's even more important than the fact that he's hurt.
And they'll send Quinn Grovey back in the ballgame. There is the timeout story. Grovey comes back in. Now, the play clock is down to 8 seconds as they took a lot of time getting Grovey into the ballgame. Down to three. He's got to hurry and get this snap off. That cost him five, and he took it right down to one. And Grovey hit even before he could execute the offense at all. Aldrich and Bobby Duncombe in on the stop. And I'm sure Texas has made up its mind that Arkansas is not going to throw the ball
right
now. You
got it, and you know they're not going to throw it, and I know they're not going to throw it. In fact, if I was the Arkansas coach, I would not pitch the ball. I would give the ball to the fullback, let him go in there, let him tackle him, let them use a timeout, punt the ball, and try to win the ball game with the crowd in the fourth quarter on defense.
Got to applaud Grovey on that last play. The clock was running down. He took it down to 1 second before he got the snap. He was very well aware of it. Clock is ticking down again. 2:37 left in the game. Delay to Rouse. And it's Hagee and Hager. They have been everywhere today. They drive them out of bounds. The clock will continue to run, however. And we're down to 2:22. Remember, Texas has only one timeout to stop that clock. They need a touchdown. A field goal will do them no good.
Please repeat that one more time.
A field goal will do them no good, but if they had kicked it before, a field goal could win the game for them.
That's not a second guess, that's a first guess.
And it's also a fact. They show 10 guys who might be coming after Kendall Trainer. Here's the rush, and they almost got there. Trainer got bumped, but he acted his way into that. Metcalf will try to bring it back, but not a soul back there to block for him. And he got it back to the 45-yard line. 1:48 to go in the game. Don't go away. Under 2 minutes to go. Texas down by four. Here are the stats on the guys that may decide it. Stafford, 16 out of 25, 128 yards. Metcalf, 75 rushing, 63 receiving. Stafford over the middle. Norris had the ball separated. They're calling it a fumble. And it looks like Arkansas has it. Let's see. They're still fighting for the ball as Norris was just drilled by Atwater. Or it looks like Atwater may have the fumble recovery. I think it was a questionable call, and whether it was a catch or not, Lee, very close.
Well, it was to our back because, in fact, we couldn't see it. But remember, he's got to control the ball, at least have it in his hand for 1 second before it's a fumble.
And Alan Champagne, the offensive center, is down there. What a break for Texas, and what hustle by Champagne to get the football.
Number 54, Champagne, he's blocking in there. All of a sudden, Norris gets hit right here and drops the football by Owens. But Champagne hustles right there and takes it away from three of the Arkansas players.
Stafford back to throw again. Dumps it off to Metcalf. He'll get 3 or 4 yards, and that's it. But it'll be enough for a first down. I have to apologize to the official. It looked like an excellent call. Did look like a catch on the replay. I don't do that very often. Own up to my own mistake. 1:20 to go in the game. First down, Texas. Arkansas 44. Three-man rush. Dump it off to Metcalf again. Shell hit him. He'll go down at the 39. Now, Texas only has one timeout left. 5 yards a pop, they're going to run out of time.
But they're in the two-minute drill, which means they're lining up. Now, he's liable to throw it out of bounds pretty soon.
Here's the draw play to Samuels, and Samuels is stopped at the 37. Wayne Martin made the tackle. That takes a lot of time.
And what it does is disruption. Now you've got to call a play on the line of scrimmage instead of going back in a huddle.
On third and a long four. Stafford in trouble again. Got Samuels. And Samuels dives to the 32-yard line. That should be good enough for another first down. And Stafford really kept his cool.
What Stafford should do right now is throw the ball out of bounds.
So he has a chance to talk it over.
Say, look, man, what's going on? Throw it out of bounds right now. Stop the clock and get back in the huddle.
Clock restarts. Stafford on a roll. Throws incomplete. Off the hands of Jorick Battle and Otis Lloyd. If he could have gotten a hand up quick enough, would have had a 70-yard interception return.
This time he throws a little bit too far behind him, and a ball deflects. Last week we had a game where LSU won the ball game on a deflection like that. So it's a dangerous play. Now he's been going to Metcalf, He might want to try to fake Metcalf underneath and get somebody into the corner for a touchdown.
Well, they've either got to go deep or get the ball out of bounds. 23 seconds left. They do have the one timeout left. This is for first place in the Southwest Conference and the inside track to the Cotton Bowl. And Stafford uses that last timeout with the clock stopped with 23 seconds to go, and that hurts.
Now, you see Coach McWilliams rubbing his eyes. That's exactly what he's saying. Oh, my. But that's all right. That'll happen in a confusion in a game like this. Now, what they're talking about over there is, look, throw the ball straight. Keep it on the sideline. Do not throw the ball away. And then we'll get down close enough to go into the end zone two or three times.
23 seconds to go. And the one thing Texas has not been able to do this year in its passing game is get anyone deep.
Well, so what they're going to do now probably is try to run the ball and give it to Metcalf underneath and let him break a tackle and run it. See, if you can't throw the ball long, Mike, what you do is try to throw it short to a guy that can run it and let him run long.
Don't go anywhere. Alabama and Tennessee coming up right after this one. This is going to be my final college game of the year. We'll be going back to doing the pros in a couple of weeks. Our first game on November 8th, the Giants and New England. and I've really enjoyed working with Lee Corso this year. It's really been a pleasure. And I'm going to miss you, Parker.
Thank you very much. All right, let's go over the situation. With no timeouts, remember, they've got to make a first down which stops the clock automatically. If they make a pass that's under 10 yards, the clock is going to run, and the Arkansas players are instructed to lay on the receiver and don't let him up.
Second and 10, Texas. Four-man rush. And Metcalf can't get it. 18 seconds left.
Number 83, Wayne Martin, come back from a knee injury. He might have almost won the game right there on that play. He put tremendous pressure on number 10 Stafford and made him throw it a little bit too quick, and he threw it wild to Metcalf. Metcalf was trying to kick the football and get up the sideline and step out of bounds and stop it. Good call by Texas.
18 seconds. They risk now a complete pass over the middle. They might not get another play. And there's the pass over the middle. It's incomplete. 14 seconds to go.
They should almost be happy it was incomplete. Because if that had been a complete pass, the game would have been open. Because he throws to the tight end. Now watch, the tight end's got to get at least 10 yards. He catches the football and drops it. But good for him that he dropped it. Because if he'd have caught the ball, the clock would have went out and they'd have lost the ball game.
Reggie Hall on the coverage. It is 4th and 10. Last gasp for the Longhorns. Metcalf! And he got out of bounds. At the 13-yard line, the guy you knew they had to go to, and somehow he got open.
But that time they sent Jones. That was a nice call by the coaches because they sent Jones as decoy and hit Metcalf, and he was right near the end zone. Makes a good catch, and Martin gets out of bounds. Now, he got to throw it out of bounds.
Stafford throws it out of bounds with 4 ticks left on the clock. Texas will get one more shot at the end zone.
Now, he must throw the ball in the end zone. I lost a big game against Iowa because we completed a 9-yard pass in a situation where we needed 10, and we lost the ball game. He must throw the ball in the end zone. Arkansas is taking timeout to remind the players they've got to throw the ball in the end zone, keep everybody in front of you. If he tackles it, everybody tackles high and get around him in pursuit. That's exactly what Arkansas is talking about.
We want to take this chance to thank our spotters, Steve Ross and Mike Carr, working with us on statistics today. Eric Trainer, Doug Calloway, and of course, as always, John Madry. We thank them for their efforts today. And with 4 seconds left, we have had a great game, a typical Arkansas-Texas game from Little Rock.
Now, let's go over what's going through Coach McWilliams' mind. Number one, Metcalf's as good a player as we can find, but don't bring him out of the backfield because he can't get deep enough. Put Metcalf in the wing, send him across the middle, send Jones to the corner, and throw it to either one of them to the left side over here.
Stafford has talked with David McWilliams. The entire Arkansas defense has been on the sideline talking with Ken Hatfield. And this is it. Win or lose, rides on this play. And we had movement in the Texas offensive line. That'll cost them 5 yards.
Chetan, the left guard, put his hand down, and he moved it.
Ball start on the offense. They'll send him out.
That doesn't hurt him at all.
No. This is Hatfield's reaction as the flag drops. And he was saying, somebody move. 4 seconds left. Fourth down. Stafford to Jones. Touchdown, Texas. Holy cow.
What a catch.
To go, no time on the clock, and Stafford hits Jones with a bullet.
On the left side of the field, they used Metcalf is a decoy on the left-hand sideline. Two players jumped him, and Stafford threw the ball right straight in there for a touchdown. What a great win for Texas.
Tony Jones with his first touchdown catch of the year, and Stafford comes back to redeem himself on the final play of the game, and the people here in Arkansas are absolutely stunned. 16-14. And Texas will remain undefeated in the Southwest Conference. Arkansas loses its first, and there is no one out there to try the point after.
Now watch the replay on this one. You'll watch number 20. Watch number 2 in the left-hand part of your picture. He's a decoy. Watch Stafford throw it right smack in the middle of all those players to Jones, who makes a fantastic catch, who gets hit by Atwater. It's a touchdown. And remember I told you, he shouldn't have gone for that field goal. Make it more exciting. Oh, this is a wonderful play. You got it. This is the kind of game, Mike, you hate to see either team lose.
Yep.
What a great play.
And David McWilliams on the sideline. He probably can't believe that they can get it, but they did. And it was a great pass and an even better catch because Jones made a brilliant catch. And Ken Hatfield just distraught on the sideline as a win goes his way. Our final score here in Little Rock. Texas on the final play of the game beats Arkansas 16-14.